Welcome back to the channel today. Twitter video. Of course, we're talking about Batwoman on Twitter. The ratings are in from Sunday night. They're a little bit better than they were, but relax, relax. This show ain't getting better anytime soon. People were ecstatic to see Batwoman compared to the Grammys. I can't even say that with a straight face. Let's get into the video. Monkeys, roll the footage. All right, as we look over the ratings from season one here, okay? Now, the highest rated episode from season two, which I will show you in a moment, only beat 4 episodes out of 16 from season one, all right? That means that the entirety of season two has been rated lower than season one, except for one episode. One that drew 708,000 viewers, which is terrible for a series that they put so much time and money into. Here we are, here we are, here we are, back season two ratings. Now as we look, we see this last episode at 552,000 people. That's a jump of 21% from 456,000. Still the fourth lowest rated episode in the entirety of the series run. That's 27 episodes at this point it's had, and this is the fourth lowest rated episode. Like I said, only one episode from season two, which is episode 3, scored 708,000 viewers and a 0.16 in the demo, has rated higher than any of the season one episodes, despite having a new lead actress that is more physically believable in the role, but her performance has been lackluster. All right, gang, main event time. We went through a brief history of the ratings and discussed it. Now, let's get on to some Twitter Batwoman fun, shall we? But first, let me cue up that beautiful music. There it is. Isn't that nice? Every situation needs a catalyst, and here was the catalyst for this. My tweet. This show is pathetic. The ratings, the writing, the cast are who suffers because they're contractually obligated to perform their roles despite being subjected to garbage tier writing. Plus, they're trying to run more story arcs than the idiots writing can handle. Seems pretty rational, right? I mean, I could have done without the ad hominems. At some point, you want to poke the bee's nest and see what flies out, right? And my tweet drew the ire of Siggy at maskripper.org, which We'll talk about that more later, but he said,
"Troll detected! Look out! Oh no, here's a troll talking bad about Batwoman."
Somehow I messed up screenshotting and I went back and they've deleted most of my comments. This guy actually blocked me, which we'll talk about in a little bit, but Siggy says,
"The TV ratings don't prove anything, especially as the CW, which is basically a streaming service. They are promoting their own streaming service a lot more than the TV airing. The TV ratings on the CW are equally important as the latest sales of fax machines."
Now, I responded to Siggy, and this is what he came back at me with.
"Interesting definition of nobody, but okay after ... I stop here. Doesn't make sense to talk to you creatures anyhow."
After I responded with a coherent response, he came back with this.
"By creatures, I mean trolls like you, who post on Twitter channels of shows they hate, and why you review bad television shows from your perspective. In your spare time, wouldn't it be better to watch stuff you actually like? But okay, it's your time."
And just to clarify, I do review shows that I like and watch things that I actually like. I don't necessarily review them because, let's be honest, my audience doesn't give a shit about The Walking Dead, WandaVision, or most of the shows that I actually enjoy. I agreed to cover this show, Batwoman, in its entirety after I reviewed all the initial trailers released in 2019, because I'm a man of my word and I gave my word to my subscribers. So if you're new to the channel, this is why I continually review Batwoman. They are consistently my most watched videos next to my live streams. So that's why I do it. I have 50 Batwoman videos on my channel and 47 Star Wars videos, and I'm predominantly a Star Wars guy. This is the guy who I was going back and forth with. He blocked me, but we'll go back and we'll look at his maskripper.org website at the end of this video because, oh It's beautiful, trust me. Here we are, the best of the rest. These are the other tweets I have from this week in Batwoman.
Yeah, she was definitely thinking gay, going to her woman's like that. Love her!
This is when Ryan's dumbass went to Angelique's house in full bat regalia, talking to her like she fucking knew her in front of her girlfriend who was dressed in a sexy panda onesie. And then some dipshit made this image, which they said,
I'm buying this!
To which I saved the picture and I'm going to make a meme out of it and I'll post it on Twitter and tag CW Batwoman and the Batwoman Writers Room in Twitter account as well, because let's just face it, they're all idiots. Here we have another mental midget named Bash Jr. who says,
yes, this is awesome.
Kind of makes you wonder what his definition of awesome actually entails, doesn't it? Here we have our old buddy Righties in the only Stan Batwoman account on Twitter, I swear to God. Completely fake. It's probably one of the heifers from the CW Writers Room. It reads,
we are hoping to see Batwoman in the movie this summer 2021 at Javicia Leslie.
Shut the fuck up, Donnie. Shut the fuck up, Donnie.
Here's another misguided, enthusiastic tweet. This is from
Spectra Phantom. Episode 7 was mad. Hands up emoji, hands up emoji.
Here's one from Shadow of Eat a Lot of Ass a Lot. I don't know. It says,
I saw the episode last night at CW Batwoman. I want to see more. I'm curious what's going to happen next. I can't wait, Steve.
Ben Bankston says,
the story is heating up.
Here's a weirdo who looks like his profile picture was probably from the county jail, and it's funny he calls himself Uncle Mike, because yeah, I can see Uncle, never mind. But Uncle Mike says,
kudos to Rachel and the writers for building a character we love to hate.
No, you fucking twat. They built a character that we're basically apathetic towards, because the only reason she's visible or actually we acknowledge her existence on the screen is because she chews the fucking scenery. That's what Rachel Skarsten does. It's not the writers. It's her acting above the writers. I guess kudos to Rachel is right, but not the writers. The writers are garbage. They're shit. Here is another absolute gem. This is from DJ Scribe.
At CW Batwoman writers, about time Mary got a storyline of her own. Z's. She certainly has the acting chops and the audience engagement cred for it. Tired of watching her run round like a freaking headless cheerleader, .. redundant much, on the periphery of other actors' active lives.
Oh my god, you all have the best writers I have ever seen. Lovesies to see them do write a Batwoman movie script.
Here's an absolute gem from Fizzy.
Yes for the new episode. Yes for the upcoming angst. Hashtag Batwoman.
Here are a couple of those Ruby Rose stands that we know are out there. First, let's start with Doctor Strange.
Bring back Katie's.
And then we have Soy Boy Extraordinaire Clay Stajani down here who says,
Kate Kane was better than Ryan. Bring back the real Batwoman.
Apathetic emoji? I don't know. Oh god, these people are just, they're sad. They're really sad. Here's our old pal Siggy from Mask Ripper. Now, he runs a website that basically fetishizes female superheroes wearing masks. He's from Germany, so there's that. He says,
things are heating up big time. Seems like we're heading to some kind of mid-season finale.
Well, yeah, that's what happens in the middle of the season, you fucking idiot. But no, seriously, I had to view this from my secondary account because he blocked me on my main one. So I used my secondary account to go check out some more tweets, and I saw our old buddy Thicky's tweet there. And we'll end this week off with our old buddy Maurice, the gangster of love.
He was a retard.
If you remember him from our first Batwoman Twitter video, him and I had a back and forth. He refuses to acknowledge me now. He hasn't blocked me, though. He says,
this series is such a jump forward from last season. Every episode keeps getting better in the storytelling, characterizations, and most of all, performances. Every character has more to do with better motivations. The action scenes are becoming spectacular. All leads are killing it.
You serious?
That's it. That's the video this week. What do you guys think? The Batwoman Twitter. It's kind of getting better. I love these tweets from these people. They're absolutely insane, especially the guy who blocked me. Yeah, that just never gets old. It's like, dude, how rattled are you that I brought up how bad the writing is on the show and still gave a nod to the actors? You know, I don't know. These people are insane, though. I never thought we would get to this level where, I mean, I can't say I never thought we'd get to this level where people are defending the show, because I've seen people defend worse, trust me. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to bitch slap that like button for me. Tune in tonight, 8:30 Eastern. We're going rogue, episode 14. Join myself, Tony Tone Deaf, as we dive into the world of pop culture. I do a little bit of monologuing. We have holy shit news. That's right. Tune in. I'm Etepo Kuyan from The Place to Be Reviews. I've been here with all of yous. And remember, if I don't see you, have a great day, a pleasant tomorrow, and I'll catch you on the next one.